Hello children, welcome back. Today we will start new chapter in civics. Chapter number 6, rural administration. Yes, as you know that in previous chapter we study about what is Gram Sabha and what is the role of a sarpanch and other panchayat members. They solve the problems of the Gram Sabha like water issues. Then we discuss about already BPL card related problems, and here through this we come to know about the village administration. So here in detail we study about rural administration. As you know that India is a democratic country and around 60-70% people are involved in farming, means they are involved in agriculture. So here that's why we study about rural area. Rural means a village area. So first of all, you try to understand there are more than 6 lakh villages in India, and taking care of their needs means a rural government. In the basic level, already we study about three levels of panchayat. First is a gram panchayat in a village level. Then we talk about Panchayat Samiti, means a taluka place, and third one is a district panchayat, means a zila panchayat. So here we study about the government, the role of government. Government taking care of their needs for water, then electricity, road connections, bridge, and government provide them education facility which is given by free of cost, as well as healthcare system. So government provide them in a rural area different facilities. So through this chapter we try to understand village administration. So now here in this chapter they give one story to better understand this chapter. This is the story of rural area based on a quarrel in the village. Mohan is a farmer. In this story mainly two characters are there and how they solve their problems. First is a Mohan. Mohan is a farmer. His family owned a small agricultural land which they have been farming for many years. Next to his field is a Raghu's land which is separated from his by a small boundary. In government word we are using boundary as a bud. So small boundary called a bud. One morning when Mohan noticed that Raghu has shifted the bud means boundary by a few feet. By doing so means Raghu cheated with Mohan. He has managed to take over some of Mohan's land and increase the size of his land. Mohan was angry at that time when he noticed, but also a little frightened. Why he frightened? Because Raghu's family owned many fields, and besides his uncle was also sarpanch of the village. Yes, that's why Mohan little bit he frightened to talk with Raghu, and he went to Raghu's house. A heated argument followed by Raghu, and that time Raghu refused to accept that he had moved the bird. Yes, he denied that he can't change the boundaries. He called one of his helper, means Raghu called his helper, and they begin shouting at Mohan and beating him up. The neighbor heard and rushed the spot where Mohan was being beaten up. They took him away. At that time you saw some bias are there, because here you saw Mohan is a small farmer, and in other hand Raghu is a big zamindar. Yes, lot of lands. lot of agricultural field. And another thing is, his uncle is also sarpanch of the village. So he was badly hurt on his head and head. He was even first aid by one of his neighbors. His friend, means whose friend? Mohan's friend, who also ran the village post office, suggested that they go to the local police station and file a report. At that time, many suggest that he went to police station and complain for this quarrel. Others were doubtful if this was a good idea, because they felt they would waste a lot of money and nothing would come out of it, because he is a landlord person, Raghu is a landlord person, and his uncle is a sarpanch. Some people said that Raghu's family would have already contacted the police station. So, after much discussion, it was decided by the Mohan would go to the police station along with some of the neighbors who had seen this incident. So, through this story, you try to understand some problems, some conflicts of village. So, after this, we study about what was happened in this story. Here, we discuss about new topic, that is area of the police station. Now, what happened? They both, Mohan and Raghu, complained their report in police station. Means, Mohan went to police station and he complained about Raghu. So, one of the way to the police station, one of the neighbor asked, why don't we spend some more money and go to the main police station in the town area? Yes, other suggested about their suggestions, how we complain a report. So, it is not a question of money. We can register the case only in this police station, because our village comes in its area of work. Who explained this? Mohan. So, as you know that every police station has an area that comes under its control. Means, where you live, there is a certain area is covered in a police station. In your village or in your city, you saw many police stations are there. But you saw, we went to that place, this area is covered in a certain police station. So here, to give you some example, all persons in that area can report cases or inform the police about any theft, about any accident, injury, or in the case of fight. At that time, we complain a report to the police. Yes, police is a kind of government officers. They follow some laws, rules and regulations, and their work is to help other common people or the citizens of their village. So here, it is the responsibility of the police of that station to inquire and investigate and take action on the cases within its area, and they search what is the reason behind it. The work at the police station, what they done at that time. So here, when they reached the police station, Mohan went to the person in charge. It is called as SHO. The full form of SHO is Station House Officer. He's a one kind of policeman whose post is HSO, and told him what had happened. He also said that he wanted to give a complaint in writing. The SHO rudely brushed him aside and saying that he couldn't be bothered to waste his time writing down minor complaints. Means he tell that if it is a small thing or a minor thing, you solve by yourself and then investigate them. But Mohan showed him his injuries, but the SHO did not believe him. So at that time, what Mohan done? He did. He showed some evidences, some proof. He called his some neighbors, and then Mohan was puzzled and did not know what to do at that time. He was not sure why his complaint was not being recorded by police. So he went and called his one of the neighbors into the office, and they argued strongly that Mohan had been beaten up in front of them, and had they not rescued him, he would have been injured very seriously. So they insisted that the case be registered. Finally, at that time, officer agreed, and he asked Mohan to write down his complaint and also told the people that he would be sent a constable the next day and investigate about this incident or about this query. So through this small story, we try to understand that some officers, means government, should appoint some persons and they follow some rules and regulation. So here they give you the example of SHO. Means, who is the SHO? SHO means station house officer, who investigate and then they take action. Here, maintenance of land record. After the investigation of police, here we try to understand about the maintenance of land record. You saw the story of Mohan and Raghu were arguing heatedly whether the common boundary of their field had been changed, means had been shifted. Isn't there a way by which they could have settled this dispute in a peaceful manner? Yes, definitely. Some government officers who record all the detailed information about the rural area or the about agricultural field. Are there any record that show who owned that land in the village? Then let's find out how this is done in rural area. Measuring land and keeping land record is the main work of the patwari. Yes, patwari is also another kind of officers who keeping the record of the villages or the land areas. The patwari is known by the different names in different states. In some villages, such officers are called as Lekhpal, then in other Kanungo, or in other areas, in certain areas, you saw Karmachari or village officers, etc. So we will refer to this officer as a Patwari. So what is the work of a Patwari? How Patwari record all the things? So each Patwari is responsible for a group of villages. The Patwari maintain and update the record of the villages. So the map and the corresponding detail from the register on the next page are a small part of a record kept by a Patwari. The Patwari usually has ways of measuring agricultural field. In some places, a long chain is used. In the above instance, the Patwari would have measured both the land of Mohan and Raghu's field and compare it then with the measuring on the map. If they did not match, then it would be clear that the boundary of the field has been changed. So through the evidences of Patwari's report, they match with the field and they identify who is the criminal over here. So the Patwari is responsible for organizing the collection of land revenues. Land revenues means a kind of taxes which is collected by patwari from the villagers. From the farmer and providing information to the government about the crops grown in this area. This is done from the record that are kept, and this is why it is important for the patwari to regular update this. Farmers may change the crops grown on their field, or sometimes they may dig a well somewhere. So all the things recorded by patwari. Here, keeping a record of all the villagers or is the work of a revenue department of the government. Here, senior people in this department supervise the patwari's work. Here we are talking about all states in India are divided into district for managing matters relating to land. This district are further divided into subdivisions, means subdivided. Here, these subdivisions of a district are known by different names, such as tehsil or taluka place. So here, at the head is the district collector in a district level, and under her are the revenue officer who collect taxes from the citizens or the person from the villages, also known as tehsildar. Yes, in a taluka place you saw tehsildar, means who is also appointed by the government and he is also a government officer. So here you saw different officers are there. They have to hear the disputes. They also supervise the work of a patwaris. Patwaris, they done their work properly or not, and ensure that record are properly kept and land revenue is collected. They make sure that the farmer can easily obtain the copy of their record. Student can obtain their caste certificates when they wanted to get admission in other colleges or when they are entering into a different institutions. They get caste certificates from this tehsil office. The tehsildar's office is where land disputes are also heard. So here we talk about the farmers and how they get different documents from the tehsildar, and how tehsildar kept record of patwari's work and other. They solve the problems of villagers also. In our this chapter, they give you one poem of a daughter's wish. Through this poem, we try to understand why they give this poem and what is the main motto of this poem. Father inherited our house from his father, and everyone says he will leave it to brother. But what about me and my mother? As you know that India is you saw male dominance is there. So we give respect to generally brothers or the males, especially males. And in ancient time also, women can't get respect from the society. So that's why in this poem you learn lot of things about women. To expect a share in my father's home is not very womanly, I am told. But I really want a place of my own, not dowry of silk and gold. Yes, means this daughter, she demanding her right, equality, and she tell us lot of things. In ancient time, people demanded for dowries, for gold, for rupees at the time of marriage. So she tell us that I am also a equal like my brother. So you also give me the respect and property like my brother. As you know that patwari keeping record of the land in village area, so student look at here, I will show you khasra report which is already given on page number 52. This report shown you the detailed information about the land of Raghu and Mohan. So here in the below side they give you map also. First, in first column they give you the information about the area in hectares, means after that the second column is name of owner, third one is it is rented to some other farmer or not, then area cultivated this year. In this column they divided this column into three parts. First is a crop grown, then area, and second crop grown in the same field or not, and after that here they shown you area not cultivated follow land. So through this report we come to know about the detailed information about Raghu and Mohan's field. After this, in the below side they give you the map of khasra report, means patwari keeping the record of map and the detail information here. So here they shown you the first agricultural land is 0.75 hectares. So first you try to understand 1 hectare is equal to 10,000 square meter, and this is, who is the owner of this land? Mohan, the son of Raja Ram, and he lived in a village Amrapur. Then next, it is rented for some other farmer, so answer is no. Crop grown, so Mohan grown soyabean in his field. Then area of cultivation, so area is 0.75, means he cultivate in a whole farming area. Second crop grown, so answer is no, dash is here. Area not cultivating follow land, so here we give us dash. Then second field is, which is here they give you the information is, which is in 3 hectares. This is the land. Who is the owner of this land? Raghu. Raghu is the son of Ratan Lal, and he live in the same village, Amrapur village. So if it is rented to some other farmer, so answer is no. Area cultivating this year, so he grown 2 crops. First is a soya bean and second one is wheat. He irrigated. So total area for cultivating is 2.75 hectares, and the second crops grown in 1.75 hectares, and other rest of the part means a 0.25 hectare. This area is cultivated follow land. Yes, in this area in the map they shown you well is there. And last one, third information, which is about, this is the government land of Madhya Pradesh, which is in total area is 6 hectare. If it is rented to some other farmer, so answer is no. So here this is the grassland, and in this land you show they shown us one well is also there and one tree. In unmap they give you the detailed information about this area, the area of government. Then in the below side they shown you the map or the boundary area of Amrapur village. Then they give you some symbols, the symbols of boundary, well, grassland, kaccha road and pakka road. After that at last they give you the information about how many trees are there in a single field. So through this map we come to know about the detailed information about the, which is keeping record by the patwari. Okay, here we study about a new law. As you know that in ancient time we can't consider girl and boy, means a man and woman, equally. But But nowadays, we follow this rule of equality. We believe after the democratic government as a equality. We believe in unity, we live with the brotherhood, we live with the equality. So here, a new law was applied after the 2005. So what is this rule? In detail we study about this Hindu Succession Amendment Act 2005. After 2005, we all follow this rule. Often when we think of farmers who own land, we think of men and women are seen as people who work on the field, but not as people who own agricultural land. Till recently in some state, Hindu women did not get a share in their family's agricultural land. After the death of her father or his property was divided equally only among his sons, but girl child can't get share of her father's family, father's property. Recently the law was changed. In the new law, son, daughter and their mother can get an equal share in the land. The same law will apply to all the state and union territories of the country. We are talking about in India, this law was applied after the 2005. This law will benefit a large number of women. For women empowerment, this law is very helpful for us and it plays a very vital role for the development of women. For example, Sudha is the elder daughter of an agricultural family. She is married and lives in a neighboring village. After her father's death, Sudha often come to help her mother with the family's work, with the farming work. Her mother has asked the Patwari to transfer the land and enter her name along with the name of all the children in his record. Sudha's mother confidently organized the farming with the help of younger brother and sister. Similarly, Sudha also lived with the assurance that if she ever has a problem, she can always depend upon her share of the land. Yes, she definitely get her right because of this law. So through this chapter, we get different work of a different officers. The chapter has looked at some of the administrative work of the government, especially about rural areas. Like here, first of all, we saw the work of a police officer. Then we study about the work of a patwari. Then we try to understand such as the tehsildar and superintendent police. They all try to solve the queries or the quarrels of the Mohan and Raghu, and how they keeping the record, and how government will provide different services in a rural area. Like here we discuss about some services in the village area, such as the milk society, the fair price shop. What is mean by fair price shop? In Gujarati we said it ration shop. In this shop, all the farmers get different food grain in a very less price. The bank, the police station, the agricultural society, which gives loan to the farmers and provide different facilities. For seed and fertilizer, the post office, the sub post office and Anganwadi. Anganwadi, which is a one kind of service for small children for getting education. Then here you saw some public services, like some Anganwadi teachers improve the life of women in rural area. So through this chapter we get lot of information about rural area. I hope you understand this chapter. Thank you.